Okay, so I'm going to give you guys a little commentary over this workout. I started off with stiff leg deadlifts and I used a barbell. I like using the barbell because I feel like it kind of allows me to keep constant tension on both hamstrings, even though sometimes I struggle when I'm doing using dumbbells or doing single legged to keep the tension. So I started off with just complete tension on hamstrings, and that actually felt really good. You was just another nigga on the hit list, trying to fix any issues with a bad bitch. Didn't they tell you that I was a savage? Fuck your white horse and a carriage. But you never could imagine, never thought you could have it. You. I then moved into single leg since I had kind of got both hamstrings working together already. And when I do these, I really like to keep the leg that is not being used higher up in the air when I go down, because I feel like it allows me to stretch more of my hamstring. And then I kind of also try to pull up through the glutes a little bit. You'll see that in probably the next video a little bit more so. Now you had to confess, but baby, who you need in me? You've been rolling around, should I roll it up? Let her roll it up. Break it down like a punch, it would never rust. She would never rust. That's the real on the real, are you serious? How you feel, how you feel? Used to trip off that shit I was kicking to you. Had some fun on the run, though. Here is where I actually was pulling a little bit more through the glutes. As you can tell, my pelvis is a little bit more tucked under me. My lower back is still tight in all positions, but it is a little bit more tucked, and I kind of pull through the glutes a little bit more at the top, and I'm not bringing the dumbbells straight up, so I'm not standing completely straight, because I like to keep a little bit of tension on the hamstrings at all times, and having that position keeps them a little bit more loaded than just standing straight vertically. Next, I moved on to the hyperextension, and I kept my upper back rounded a little bit, and I really pulled through my glutes. It looks weird, it feels weird, and you just honestly have to think of just squeezing your butt as hard as you can when doing this, and it's awkward, but who cares? You're in the gym to, you know, do this for yourself, so if anybody thinks that, you know, that looks weird, whatever, they're not gonna have as nice of a butt as you will, just saying. I supersetted these with the hyperextension. These are just some basic crab walks with a band. I put the band right above my knee, and I basically just try and pull and drag through my glutes and really focus on them. I'm also very glute dominant, so it's not very hard for me to feel the burn in my booty, but did some of those. And the deeper you are into a squat, the harder the movement is. The more vertical you are, the easier it is. Just saying, if you really want to make it hard, go deep. Then I moved into some Bulgarian split squats, and I was just holding basically a 10-pound medicine ball, but you can also hold a dumbbell, kettlebell, whatever it may be. It's a little difficult to find your positioning on this movement, but once you do, it honestly feels great, and I feel like it's really helpful to just develop your legs overall. You also do not want to be too close to the bench. You do not want to be too far away from the bench. So you kind of have to find that happy median where your knee will just sit kind of on the middle of your foot or a little bit more forward. I've talked a lot about the reverse hyper kind of on Instagram and things like that, but this is honestly such a great movement to help build your lower back and your posterior chain in general. It is very difficult, but it is the only movement that will really isolate your low back. So
since I am cutting, I am doing cardio, and I always keep cardio kind of in my training regimen anyway. So I was doing 5 calories on the assault bike, and then I moved directly into 10 wall balls. If you don't have an assault bike at your gym, you kind of just need to come to Stronger Athletics and use one. I'm kidding. But definitely try and get your hands on an assault bike if you can. They're extremely intense, and it's just a great way to annihilate your cardio session, honestly. And I basically was doing 5 calories on the assault bike, 10 wall balls, back to back with no rest in between. I think I did 6 rounds, maybe 5. I don't really remember. The whole thing was like a blur. I was dying, felt like death, but it was really effective. Probably took me 7 minutes, maybe even less. I think the timer said 7 or 8 minutes. And honestly, HIIT is kind of growing on me. I'm starting to enjoy it more just because it doesn't take as much time to do. It is very effective, but it does require more rest and recovery because it is taxing. But you know, you kind of just have to weigh the pros and cons and see what works for you. Right now, I'm really enjoying doing 2 HIIT sessions a week, roughly.